Hello there, I hope you are having a good day and staying hydrated. Today, I thought I would just have a talk through some of these eyes that I painted. I have always loved eye studies. I've always loved using it as a way to try and improve the way that I paint eyes, but I was also really inspired by some makeup looks that I saw on TikTok and on Pinterest, and I decided to try and paint some eye makeup looks as kind of mini studies. So that's what I did. So I thought we could just go through today and tell you a little bit about each of them and why I think they might be helpful and what I learned. So this very first one I think is actually my favorite. The main thing that I really struggled with when I was doing these makeup looks was honestly, at what stage do you stop blending skin and try and add eyeshadow, because it's kind of difficult. I added the pink, but by that point I feel like it was already a little bit too dark. But I also didn't really have a clear eye makeup look in my head of what I was gonna do, so I just tried to add some liner and make it a little bit kooky. I found this was a really fun way for me to create like loads of little TikToks and to create content, but also try and practice with the way that I paint eyes and try and get some practice in. And I just found it really fun also looking at all of the different eye makeup looks and trying to get inspiration. The liner I don't think is exactly realistic. I don't think it would sit on the eyes like that in the angle that I did it in. So I think I might need to look at some more references to try and figure that out. I say that just because I think the nose would probably be a little bit narrower and the eyeliner would actually bend a little bit close to the nose, if that kind of makes sense. I decided to use green and a little bit of indigo for the eyes just because I felt like with the ginger eyebrows and the pastel pink shades, I thought green would just really make it pop, and I do think this was a lovely idea. Lashes, I really struggle with. I tried painting on the lashes, but honestly, it's kind of a 50-50 nowadays whether I'm going to add lashes or not, because I think a lot of the time it kind of ruins it. I'm not good enough, and sometimes I don't want to ruin it. But I really love how this one has turned out. For the second one, I decided to do just an eye on its own because honestly, sometimes it's a lot more fun not having to worry about symmetry and trying to make them the same. Doing one eye by itself, I think, is one of the most fun things that you can paint. That might just be a personal preference, but I think it really is. I decided to do a similar colour for the eyebrow just because the skin tone was really light, so I didn't feel like the eyebrows would be very dark really in comparison. But as I say, I wasn't really following a reference for this one. But I do think the lashes are definitely an improvement in this one. It was quite a difficult angle to try and paint, but I do like this eye makeup look. I think it's really quite fun and I'm really quite happy with how this one turned out. Following on from that, I decided to do another single eye, but this one I decided to do the right eye and it was really difficult. I don't know if this is like a really common thing for other people, but 95% of the eyes that I draw and paint are always the left eye. I prefer it. I think it might be because I'm right-handed and the eyebrow just comes a little bit more naturally for me, or adding the liner comes a bit more naturally, but doing the right eye as a right-handed person, I just found it very difficult. And then I don't know if other people have preferences like that, but that's something I found. For this one, I did the skin tone a little bit darker, and the problem I had with that was any kind of eyeshadow that I tried to add to it would kind of turn muddy because there was already a layer of basically brown down. Also, because a lot of my watercolors are very transparent, it just wouldn't have really worked. So I decided to do a little bit of a eyeliner look. I used my Naples yellow just because it has white in the mixture, so I felt like that'd be something that would be able to layer on top quite easily. If I had used, say, a transparent blue or pink, I just don't think it would have given the look of eyeshadow. I think on top of the brown, it would have just looked a little bit weird. So I decided to do liner instead. I think I definitely need to do a lot more planning when it comes to these eye makeup looks, because it's difficult to add eyeshadow after you've already done the skin tone, but it's also quite difficult to blend eyeshadow into the skin tone, so I'm not sure how I'm gonna fix that one. This one I think might be my favourite. Rather than just an eye makeup look, it has obviously a nose. It has a little bit more of a face going on. This one was a little bit experimental. I decided to use metallic watercolour, which you'll see in a little bit. I'm not a massive fan of the angle of the face. This is my worst angle. Honestly, I just cannot do it. I've done lots of practice, even like recently, and it's just like I'm still really struggling with this angle. It's anything that's kind of a side angle to a three quarter, I really struggle with. And this one was one of those. I do really love painting eyes and drawing eyes and doodling eyes. That's like the first thing that I will always go to. I feel like when it comes to a lot of different subjects, with eyes, you literally only have to look at a few reference photos and you've suddenly picked it up. Whereas something like noses are different at different angles. Eyes don't really change that much. As long as you've got the hang of the iris and the pupil and the eyelids can be different shapes and sizes, generally, they don't really change that much. There's a lot of wiggle room, and if you're not fantastic at painting, if you don't have a ton of experience, I feel like eyes is that thing that you don't really mess up horrifically, because as long as you can look at it, generally you will always be able to recognize that it's an eye. Whereas if you try different abstract works and more difficult designs, it's harder for your brain to recognize what it actually is. At least with an eye, even if you're not happy with it, even if you think you haven't done a very good job, generally people will know what you're painting. And I feel like you don't need to be an amazing artist to paint a good eye, honestly. I think it's a lot more lenient than a lot of other subjects, and I think that's why people are generally quite keen on it. I think really I paint eyes often because I'm lacking confidence in my abilities, and sometimes I can paint an eye and I will feel better about myself and what I can produce. And I think that can really help sometimes if you need that little bit of confidence, because then it will be encouraging and you'll be inspired to create other things. And sometimes it's helpful to do really simple projects or sketchbook pages because it can help you understand your own abilities and give you the confidence you need to then jump out and explore other things. And it's also nice sometimes to create art that you're completely comfortable with, and for me that's eyes. I'm not saying like I'm amazing at them, but I did this entire page in like 2 or 3 hours, and I'm really quite happy with it for how long it took. Obviously the paper isn't incredible either, it's just sketchbook paper. I used the metallic for the eyes and the highlight, and honestly I really love that idea. This is how the page looks. I hope you've enjoyed, and maybe I've inspired you to paint some eyes because they're really fun. See you next time. Bye bye.